A rheometer, also known as viscometer, is an instrument to measure the viscosity of a liquid. The liquid can be a low viscosity water, or it can be a viscous oil or a grease. Even liquids which are more viscous than grease can be tested.
So before I talk about rheometry or rheology, let me define what is viscosity. In simple term, viscosity is the resistance to motion against shear. By shear we mean when we deform the material in such a way that we apply the force tangentially. So here we can see that, for example, if we have a layer of fluid, let's say we have got water between two plates. So this is the bottom plate and this is the top plate, and we have got a layer of fluid here. Now if we slide these two plates in this manner tangentially, then this fluid will be subjected to shear. So this is called shearing action. So the viscosity is the property of the fluid by which it resists the motion. It resists this deformation. So in this kind of shearing action, basically we can imagine that the fluid is made up of atoms and molecules, and they are arranged in this fashion. So in a very idealized situation, we can assume that the atoms and the molecules are arranged in layers, and these are the layers, different layers of the atoms and molecules, and we are shearing this. So in this case, we are shearing these layers against each other. So therefore, there will be some resistance to this motion. So this is the force. We are applying some force, and there will be resistance to this force. That means the liquid wants to come back to its original position. It doesn't want to move. So if this is the area, then the force that we apply will be proportional to the area. The more area you have, the more force you have to apply. Now, this force will also be proportional to the speed with which we are deforming. The faster we deform, the more force we have to apply. So it will be directly proportional to the speed. So V is the speed. Now, the distance between these two plates, we write as H. So the closer these plates will be, the more difficult it will be to make shear happen. So that means the force is inversely proportional to the distance between the two plates, or H. So we write H here. So now we can say the force divided by the area is proportional to the speed divided by the separation distance. Now this force divided by area, when the force is tangential, then we call it shear stress. We write by tau. So tau is the shear stress. Shear stress is proportional to velocity divided by h. So this term, velocity divided by h, is known as the shear rate. That means the rate of shearing, how fast or how slow we are shearing these molecules one over another. So in this case, we give the symbol gamma dot. So this is the shear rate. So that means the shear stress is proportional to shear rate. So we can write, and eta is the constant. And this constant, eta, is known as the viscosity. So that means if we want to know the viscosity of this fluid, then what we have to do is to make this liquid between two plates we have to shear the liquid, we have to apply the shearing action or shearing force, and we have to measure the force, we have to know the area, then we can find out the shear stress, and we have to know the velocity and h to find out shear rate. Then we can find out the viscosity as tau over gamma dot. Now this viscosity is very sensitive to temperature and pressure. So we must know what is the temperature, what is the viscosity at any given temperature, and also pressure is also extremely important. Now viscosity we can find out for simple fluids like water. So water is Newtonian fluid. So this relation is also known as Newtonian viscosity. So in this case, if we plot as a function of shear rate, then it should give us a straight line starting with zero. So this is for Newtonian fluids. Any other kind of behavior will be known as non-Newtonian fluids. So in fact, many of the liquids that we deal with in lubrication are non-Newtonian, but to some extent some are Newtonian as well. So now about rheometry or viscometry. Rheometry is basically the study of the viscosity, but it is not just Newtonian but many other types of behavior which are all non-Newtonian. So in order to measure this, find out eta, we need to have, in a simple way, we have to have two plates with liquid in between and apply some shear stress and find out the force, area, and measure this one. Other way will be to have a circular disk. So we have got liquid in between, but these two plates are circular. This is the top view. So this is the circular and we are rotating this. By rotating also we can introduce shearing action and we can find out the shear stress. In this method, one problem is that we, in order to get the parallel, these two parallels is quite difficult, can be quite difficult. So therefore to solve this problem, what we do is we have the top plate which is in the form of a cone. But this inclination, this angle is very, very small, and the bottom plate is circular disk. So this is cone and this is circular disk. So with this kind of geometry, and we fill this with the liquid, so with this kind of geometry we can measure the shear stress by measuring the torque. So we measure the torque applied, so we can find out the shear stress, and there is an equation to find out the viscosity in this kind of geometry. So this is what we do in the rheometer that I'm going to show you. Now another important thing is that often we can draw this for Newtonian fluids, but often what happens is the fluid is non-Newtonian. That means it has got some different kind of behavior. It is not linear. So in this case, so this will be non-Newtonian. So in this kind of behavior, how to find out the viscosity? So therefore a new term, apparent viscosity, is introduced. So apparent viscosity is basically viscosity at a given shear rate. And to get the apparent viscosity, we connect this point to the origin and we find out the slope of this line. So at this point, we find out the shear stress and shear rate. So viscosity apparent viscosity will be given by tau 1 by gamma 1. So this will be known as apparent viscosity. So apparent viscosity is going to change at every point. So as we move the point, as we increase the shear rate, the apparent viscosity will change. Now there are many ways to find out the viscosity, but this is the one which we will follow in our equipment. So this is called cone and plate. So by cone and plate method, we can find out the viscosity. So here the torque which we measure is given as 2 over 3 alpha. Alpha is this inclination, this angle, multiplied by pi eta omega r cube. So here alpha is this angle, eta is the viscosity, omega is the angular speed, and r is the radius of this disk. So by using this equation, what we have to do is to measure torque, and all other parameters are given, so we can calculate eta or the viscosity.
This rheometer made by Anton Parr has three sections. This lower part is temperature control chamber. This maintains the temperature of the bottom plate and the liquid specimen at a fixed temperature. The upper part has the motor to rotate the top plate, which is in the form of a cone. It also houses very sensitive torque transducer to measure the torque applied when the cone is rotated at a fixed RPM. The third part is the software that controls the motors and other electronics, as well as records the data from the torque transducer, the temperature sensor, etc. There is air bearing for the shaft to which the cone stem is attached. This is to reduce friction as much as possible. The air bearing is supplied with compressed air using an air compressor. The top cone is part of a stem which is fixed to the motor by aligning a marked line. This cone has included angle which is very close to 180 degrees. The mark on this stem is aligned with a similar mark in the holder attached to the motor of the machine. The system identifies the attachment of the cone. This is the software interface, and there are many parameters to be set here. The position of the cone is first set to 0 using the software interface. In this setting, the cone tip keeps 1 mm gap with the bottom flat plate. This avoids any contact between the cone and the bottom plate. The most basic test we can run in this machine is the measurement of viscosity as a function of the shear rate. The software records measuring time, viscosity, shear rate, shear stress, torque, etc. Now we set the position as 0. This will bring the cone to its designated point 1 mm away from the bottom plate. The machine will bring the cone to the position of 1 mm above the base plate. This position is identified as 0 position. The 1 mm gap is maintained so that the cone does not touch the base plate, as this will damage the transducers attached to the machine. The machine will also check the normal load and the torque to 0. Temperature is also shown in the display. temperature is maintained constant by a water circulation system. All the readings in this display should be okay before the machine can start measurement. The torque and the zero position should be carefully checked before starting an experiment. They are used to calculate the viscosity of the liquid. Now, if we say OK in the software, then the machine will retract the cone to the high position. Now, we can put the liquid sample on the base plate. It has a minor depression and we should only fill that much. This sample is a synthetic engine oil. Ensure that the air compressor is on, otherwise the machine will not start measurement. It is important for the safety of the machine. Now, after having placed the specimen, we can begin the measurement. Click the measuring position. The machine will initiate the measurement keeping 1 mm distance from the base plate. Now, any spillover of the liquid should be cleaned. Now, the machine asks to clean around the sample to remove only the spillover. For high viscous liquids, it is important to ensure that there is no void in the liquid specimen. Now, we can click Continue. If every parameter is fine, then click OK. Select type of test, such as constant shear rate or shear rate changing. Press Edit Shear Rate. Input the duration of measurement and measuring points. Shear rate can be ramp in. Range of shear rate can be input, for example, from 0.01 to 1000 per second. These data input are standard for all tests. Now, start the test if everything is fine. The system will ask regarding data saving. Now select the file name for the data and the folder. Now the machine has started rotating the cone and the measurements have started too. In the strain rate ramping, the RPM of the cone stem will continue to increase. The RPM continues to increase so that the shear rate can be increased. Now the test is finished. The machine retracts the cone to its original rest position. The results will be displayed in Excel format with all the parameters included. The important data of time, shear stress, viscosity, and shear rate will be shown in this datasheet. Now we can save this as Excel file. So finally, let me show you the data which we have obtained on Excel. So this data is for synthetic oil or synthetic engine oil. We conducted the experiment at 31.18 degrees Celsius temperature. So this is the Excel sheet that you will get from the machine. So all the parameters that we had input, they are all written here, and the most important is the viscosity, the shear rate, shear stress, and torque. And these two columns, this column gives you the number of points that we had set. So in this experiment we had set 100 points. So we wanted to conduct the experiment for 100 points, and these are the seconds. So starting with 6, 12, 18, so at these seconds, the test data were collected by the machine. So now here you can see that shear rate is given in per second, and shear stress is given in Pascal. So viscosity is already calculated here. So we can take the data from here. So we can see that the viscosity is in the range of 0.27 and so on. So this is the viscosity of the engine oil that we have tested, 0.277 Pascal second. So this viscosity is dynamic viscosity or absolute viscosity. So this is the data we obtained for engine oil at the given temperature of 31.18 degree Celsius. Now another data I will show you for olive oil. So we also tested the normal olive oil at the same temperature of 31.18 degree Celsius. In this case, we obtained the viscosity in this range, 0.15, 0.152, 0.155, and so on. So this is the viscosity of olive oil at the temperature of 31.18 degree Celsius, and this is the viscosity of engine oil at the same temperature. So finally, I would like to show you two graphs. So this graph is for the engine oil, and here we have got shear stress in Pascal, and here we have got shear rate in per second. And you can see that the engine oil, which is a synthetic oil, gives a linear relation here between shear stress and the shear rate. So we can say that this is a Newtonian fluid, and here we have got the viscosity as a function of shear rate. And again, we can see that viscosity does not change, it remains constant. So we can say that the engine oil is a Newtonian fluid. So if we do the similar plotting for olive oil, then we can see that this one is shear stress in Pascal, and this is shear rate in per second. So again, olive oil is also gives a linear curve, that means it is a Newtonian fluid. Here we have got the viscosity in Pascal second and the shear rate in per second. So again, we see that the viscosity does not change much. So we can say that olive oil is also a Newtonian fluid. So thank you very much for your attention and for watching this video. If you have any comment or question, please do write them down below in the comment section. Thank you.